Hello, grade 11s. Welcome to Edu-ca-te. Let us talk about cellular respiration. It is a very short topic, but most of the times in the question papers, they ask it using investigations. So now, cellular respiration, we need to know what is it so that you can have an understanding. Remember that life sciences is all about understanding what is happening. So now, we say that we need energy to do work, right? We need energy, and when we eat, we get energy. But now we get to be specific on how that energy is produced. So energy is produced in the cells. Yeah, the cells of a human being produce energy. And that energy, it is known as ATP. So cellular respiration is that process whereby the glucose in the food is broken down in the presence or in the absence of oxygen so that energy can be released, to release energy. So as we say that energy is needed by the body, so the process of cellular respiration produces energy. Yes, and that energy, we have a scientific term for it. It is known as ATP. So whenever you see the word ATP, it is referring to the energy. That is the same energy that you use to do work. Yes, the energy that you get after eating, it is known as ATP, adenosine triphosphate, but then just know it as ATP. So now, for us to have energy, glucose is a nutrient. Glucose reacts with oxygen, and then the products of that reaction will be carbon dioxide. So cellular respiration releases carbon dioxide as well as water and also the energy. But we usually focus on the energy because ATP, it is something we can relate to. Because after you eat, you are active because you have enough ATP. So now it is because glucose is broken down in the presence or in the absence of oxygen. So there are two main types of cellular respiration. We have got aerobic respiration. It is the one that needs oxygen, or the one that requires oxygen, whereas we have got another one, anaerobic or anaerobic respiration. It is the one that does not need oxygen. So during aerobic respiration, we do need oxygen, but during anaerobic respiration, we do not need oxygen. So now let's start up with aerobic respiration. So aerobic respiration occurs in the cytoplasm and in the mitochondria of a cell. Remember that you did a cell in grade 10 and you know that fluid part known as a cytoplasm as well as the mitochondria. So these are the two places where aerobic respiration takes place. So if a question in the exam asks you, what are the sites? These are the sites for aerobic cellular respiration, sites of aerobic, or you can say sites for aerobic cellular respiration. So the one that requires energy, it takes place in two places, the cytoplasm and mitochondria. So it has got three stages. It has got a glycolysis stage, a Krebs cycle, as well as an oxidative phosphorylation. So we start with the glycolysis. You should explain it exactly as I've written here. If you want to get full marks, you can just get total explaining how glycolysis happens. So glycolysis occurs in the cytoplasm. I remember I've said that aerobic cellular respiration occurs in the cytoplasm and mitochondria, but then the stage of glycolysis occurs in the cytoplasm. This is the site. So if the question asks you, what is the site for glycolysis? You're going to say the cytoplasm. So during glycolysis, what happens? The glucose is broken down. Remember that in cellular respiration, the main aim is to break down glucose so that it can release energy. And then what we form is known as pyruvic acid. When we break down glucose, we form something known as pyruvic acid. And then during that process, there is a release of an energized hydrogen as well as the ATP. Remember, the ATP is the energy that we're talking about. So in other diagrams, they can just say during glycolysis, you have got six carbons, which is the glucose. Remember that glucose has got six carbons, but then you shouldn't worry about that. So you have got a stage where glucose is broken down into two types. You can just say it's broken down into two things, which is pyruvic acid. So this is pyruvic acid. This is pyruvic acid. Pyruvic acid. So all of this happens, or it occurs in the cytoplasm. And glycolysis releases energy. So in the process, there is a release of ATP. There's a release of ATP as well as an energized hydrogen atom. So there's hydrogen, energized hydrogen. We say it is energized, it has got energy, as well as ATP. So glucose is broken down into two pyruvic acid molecules, and then ATP and hydrogen is released. That's how you explain glycolysis. Remember, this is still under aerobic respiration. Now let us move to the next step, which is known as the Krebs cycle. So the Krebs cycle occurs in the mitochondrion. So in aerobic respiration, we say that it occurs mainly in the cytoplasm, that is glycolysis, and then in the mitochondria, that is Krebs cycle, and also oxidative phosphorylation will take place in the mitochondria of the cell. So now the Krebs cycle occurs in the mitochondrion, and then that occurs in the presence of oxygen. So for glycolysis, oxygen is not really needed, although we have said that here we are explaining aerobic respiration, but glycolysis does not need oxygen. So yes, it occurs in the cytoplasm but does not require oxygen. But as for the Krebs cycle requires oxygen. So now the pyruvic acid that we have produced in glycolysis, it is used in a series of cyclic reactions, and then it produces more energized hydrogen atoms as well as carbon dioxide. So in Krebs cycle, we are just taking that pyruvic acid that we had in glycolysis process. Remember, this process, we have released pyruvic acid. So that pyruvic acid goes into a process known as the Krebs cycle. So this process is known as the, it's just a stage of aerobic respiration known as the Krebs cycle. And the Krebs cycle, it occurs in the mitochondrion. So if they ask what is the site, this word site just means the place where something happens. So now, in a sense, Krebs cycle occurs in the mitochondrion of the cell. So Krebs cycle occurs in the mitochondrion. And then what does it release? It releases carbon dioxide and even more energized hydrogen. So there is even more energized hydrogen. So this is it about aerobic respiration. We have got glucose that is broken down into pyruvic acid, which consists of three carbons. But then this is not that necessary. We just need to know that glucose is broken down into two pyruvic acid molecules. And then during glycolysis, this is glycolysis. The first part of this process is known as glycolysis, whereby the glucose is broken down. Then glycolysis releases ATP, which is energy, as well as energized hydrogen, two things that are released by the by this process of glycolysis. And then that pyruvic acid that is released, it then goes into the mitochondria so that the Krebs cycle can happen. So now this is the second step, which is known as the Krebs cycle. So that that pyruvic acid will be used in a series of reactions. So it will just be some chemical stuff, but all you need to explain is that the pyruvic acid reacts inside the what, inside the mitochondrion, and more energized hydrogen will be released as well as carbon dioxide. So remember that in that reaction, the first one, we have shown that cellular respiration releases carbon dioxide. So that is where the carbon dioxide is released by the process of the Krebs cycle. And now the last stage, which is known as oxidative phosphorylation, this one, it occurs in the mitochondrion. So it also occurs in the mitochondrion. So when the energized hydrogen atom from that glycolysis and Krebs cycle are used also to form ATP. So remember that during the process of Krebs cycle, we have released energized hydrogen atoms, more energized hydrogen atoms. Even in glycolysis, we also released energized hydrogen atoms. So now those hydrogen atoms now go through this phase known as oxidative phosphorylation. These energized hydrogen atoms, they are used to form ATP. So the energized hydrogen atoms, they can also form more energy during the process of oxidative phosphorylation. So the hydrogen, the other hydrogen will combine with oxygen so that they can form water. So water is released also during cellular respiration. Remember, again, back to our reaction, the reaction of glucose and oxygen released carbon dioxide. Remember, carbon dioxide was released during the Krebs cycle. ATP was released from glycolysis and even oxidative phosphorylation. And water was released during oxidative phosphorylation, where this hydrogen, this energized hydrogen, the other one combines with oxygen to form water. Remember that water is H2O. Is a combination of hydrogen and oxygen. So the energized hydrogen that has come from glycolysis and Krebs cycle forms water and more ATP, or more energy, more adenosine triphosphate. So that is how aerobic respiration takes place. So glycolysis, remember, it does not require oxygen. It happens in the cytoplasm, whereas oxidative phosphorylation and Krebs cycle, that occurs in the mitochondrion, and it requires oxygen. So if you explain it exactly in this way, you can get your full marks. Now let's talk about anaerobic respiration. This one, it does not require oxygen. This one does not need oxygen. So even if there is no oxygen, aerobic respiration can still take place. So anaerobic respiration, I mean, it occurs in the cytoplasm, both in plants and animals. So it only occurs in the cytoplasm. It is not like aerobic cellular respiration that occurs in both the mitochondrion and the cytoplasm, but anaerobic occurs in the cytoplasm only. So this is the site for anaerobic respiration. So if they say give the site of for anaerobic respiration, you're gonna say the cytoplasm. That's the place where the cytoplasm is the place where anaerobic respiration takes place. And then in the process of anaerobic respiration, we still release energy, but then that will be less of it. So less energy or less ATP it is released if we compare to aerobic respiration, the one that requires oxygen. Okay, so the one that does not require oxygen, the anaerobic one, this one, the anaerobic one releases less energy or less ATP. So now let us talk about anaerobic respiration in animals. So in animals, anaerobic respiration is known as lactic acid fermentation. So whenever you see the word lactic acid fermentation, they are referring to anaerobic respiration in animals, the one that does not require oxygen. So in animals, anaerobic respiration occurs in muscles. So if they ask what is the site for anaerobic respiration in animals, or maybe they say what is the site for lactic acid fermentation, you're gonna say that in muscles. So it usually occurs during exercise. Most of the times it occurs during exercise. So glycolysis occurs as well. Glycolysis also occurs in anaerobic respiration. Remember that glycolysis, that process that does not need oxygen, so it occurs in both the types. So glycolysis produces lactic acid. So remember that in aerobic respiration, we had said that the process of glycolysis will break down to pyruvic acid, but here we're gonna say that the glycolysis process will result in the production of lactic acid, and then that lactic acid makes the muscles to feel tired. So you've explained the lactic acid makes the muscles to feel tired. So when you're exercising and you suddenly feel tired, it is because the lactic acid has accumulated in your muscles, because anaerobic respiration takes place in the muscles. Lactic acid fermentation, it is the one that produces this thing known as lactic acid, and it makes your muscles to feel tired. But then the trick is that lactic acid can change to become pyruvic acid when the muscles receive oxygen. So now anaerobic respiration can still return to aerobic respiration later on. Okay, so even I'm sure we have said that lactic acid is produced in the muscles, right? And then when you receive oxygen, remember we've said that anaerobic respiration does not need oxygen, but when that lactic acid in your muscles receives oxygen, it will change and become pyruvic acid. And then remember that when it is now pyruvic acid, it will just go through the Krebs cycle and aerobic respiration will take place. So the anaerobic respiration is something temporary as long as you have not received oxygen. So that is why your muscles, when you rest, and breathe in some air and get more oxygen, your muscles will not feel tired anymore. Why? It is because that lactic acid that made your muscles to feel tired will now change to become pyruvic acid, and then your muscles will no longer feel tired. So now that lactic acid changes to become a pyruvic acid whenever those muscles receive oxygen. So now in plants, anaerobic respiration, it is known as alcoholic fermentation. So remember, in animals, it is lactic acid fermentation because we produce lactic acid. So in plants, it is known as alcoholic fermentation because we produce alcohol. So glycolysis still takes place in the alcoholic fermentation, and then it releases pyruvic acid. So in plants, we do release pyruvic acid during the process of glycolysis. Remember that in animals, we have said that glycolysis produces lactic acid, but for plants, glycolysis still releases pyruvic acid. But then that pyruvic acid is then broken down to form ethanol. It forms alcohol. It does not go through the Krebs cycle like the aerobic one. Remember that the pyruvic acid here at the aerobic respiration went through the Krebs cycle. But in anaerobic respiration or in alcoholic fermentation, that pyruvic acid is broken down to form alcohol instead. But then you should use the word ethanol, not alcohol. Ethanol is a form of alcohol, but then you should say the pyruvic acid is broken down to form alcohol, ethanol. And then in that process, carbon dioxide is also released. So this is how you explain how does alcoholic fermentation takes place. Alcoholic fermentation, it is just cellular respiration, anaerobic, the one that does not need oxygen, but then in plants. In animals, the one that does not need oxygen, it is known as lactic acid fermentation. The one that requires oxygen is known as aerobic respiration. Okay, but in all of these, glycolysis takes place. In all of these respirations, glycolysis takes place, and then glycolysis just breaks down the glucose. Okay, it's just that in animals, that glycolysis produces lactic acid, but in plants it produces pyruvic acid, just like in aerobic respiration. So I hope we are clear. So now these are the differences between aerobic and anaerobic respiration that you need to know. At least know three of them. Please, you don't have to cram everything, because in the exam you might even forget one. At least know three of your choices. From these four, know three. I don't think a question will ever ask you to give four differences between two things. That will be free marks, of which you never get free marks in grade 11. So now, you just need to know three of them. So the simple one, the most simple one, the difference between aerobic and anaerobic is that oxygen is required in aerobic respiration. In anaerobic respiration, oxygen is not required. And then the other difference is that the product of aerobic respiration is carbon dioxide and water. Remember, carbon dioxide is produced during Krebs cycle, and water is produced during oxidative phosphorylation. That is all part of aerobic respiration. But in anaerobic respiration, there is a release of lactic acid in animals. Remember, lactic acid fermentation, whereby the glucose is broken down. That glycolysis process produces lactic acid, the one that we have seen here in lactic acid fermentation. We've said that the glycolysis produces lactic acid in animals. And then in plants, it produces alcohol. It produces alcohol. And also there is carbon dioxide produced. Remember that in plants, the respiration produces carbon dioxide. You already have 4 marks just for this. Each and every difference is marked on either side. Okay, and then the third one, it occurs in the cytoplasm and in the mitochondria. So the aerobic respiration, remember we say that it occurs in the cytoplasm and the mitochondria, because in the cytoplasm, remember, glycolysis occurs there. In the mitochondria, it is Krebs cycle and oxidative phosphorylation. But the anaerobic one occurs only in the cytoplasm because it does not require oxygen. And then in aerobic respiration, there are large amount of ATP energy that is released. And glucose is completely broken down. So in anaerobic, there is a small amount of ATP energy that is released. The reason is glucose is only partially broken down. So if they say give the reason why there is small amount of ATP energy released in anaerobic respiration, you are going to say that there is a small amount of ATP energy in anaerobic respiration because glucose is only partially broken down. Or you can say not all the glucose is broken down. But for aerobic respiration, all of the glucose is completely broken down, or all the glucose will be broken down. So that is what makes the ATP to be different. In aerobic respiration, we say glucose is broken down completely. All of it is broken down and more ATP is formed. But in anaerobic respiration, some of the glucose does not break. We can just say that, but it is partially broken down. Some of it does not break. And then if it does not break, it means that there will be small amount of ATP energy. So that closes the chapter of cellular respiration. I wish you all luck for your final examinations. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Tell your friends to stay tuned.